Hi everyone, Ezekiel Callahan here to talk to you about Shuvuuia or Shuvuuia, depending on how exactly you want to say it. It's actually one of the best known alvarosaurids, a very strange group of dinosaurs with essentially just a single claw on their front hands, and it's known from the Gobi Desert of Mongolia. If you're familiar with dinosaur media, you might actually know it from the documentary Dinosaur Planet, where a CG one gets absolutely destroyed by an oviraptor in that film. However, this depiction, based on a new study, probably isn't the most correct depiction you'll see. And that's because it's very likely that Shuvuuia was actually nocturnal. The first piece of evidence to help support this is an enlarged scleral ring. The scleral ring is essentially a bone that fits around the eye that helps attach the muscles of the iris that help the pupil dilate and contract. With it being so enlarged in Shuvuuia, it helps us suggest the animal was spending a lot of its time with its pupil as wide open as possible, which would help it absorb more light so that it could see better in dark conditions. To see this idea in practice, you can take any camera essentially and just essentially give it a prolonged exposure period in a bright day. And most of the colors will be entirely washed out because essentially it's absorbing too much light to have a decent photo show up. And the same is true of eyes. Essentially, if the same amount of light is let in, if you essentially open up the iris too much light will come in and the image won't be clear. And so this is really good evidence that Shuvuuia was hunting primarily at night. The same is true for animals' eyes though. And that's because when light enters the eye and hits the back of it, chemical reactions occur. These are normally processed by the brain in order to form a proper image. However, if there's too much light that's coming in, there's going to be too much sensitivity that's happening for the brain to properly process the image. And so the animal won't exactly know what it's looking at. The second feature that helps to suggest that Shuvuuia was actually nocturnal is a structure inside the skull, and that's the inner ear. And specifically, a very small ridge on the inner ear, which has only been found in three different species. First, Shuvuuia. Second, the barn owl, or Taita alpha as it's shown in these figures. And then an unnamed troodontid, also from Mongolia. When different features for hearing in the inner ear were plotted on a graph, actually these three species do also show up much higher than any other species, including other alvarosaurs, such as Xenonychus. This means that Shuvuuia probably won't give us a good idea of what the alvarosaurs were doing as a whole, but it does indicate that in the Gobi Desert, and in specifically the Necht Formation of Mongolia, that there was probably a distinct diurnal and nocturnal fauna, and that essentially a lot of these fauna wouldn't have been interacting as much as we may have previously thought. And so we need to get more research done on this formation so we can try and understand exactly what these different communities may have looked like.